Okay, screen is visible to all of you? Is it clear?
Yes,
Hello?
sir.
Okay, this circuit diagram, these are the waveform already we have discussed in the last lecture, okay? And why we are using this PM5 because to amplify the frequency by using the transmitter, so that we have to use the PM5 circuit, okay? Starting में क्या होता है, 0 dB रहता है, then after that, we have to use this circuit, PM5 circuit. Then, using that PM5 circuit, this frequency will be amplified, or frequency will be increased due to that PM5 circuit. And this circuit is used in a transmitter. Okay, used in a transmitter. After that, modulator, balanced modulator. And in that circuit, we have to use the bandpass filter having the R and C circuit. These R and C circuits, these two are connected in a parallel, okay? When the two components they are connected in a parallel, so that we can call as a high pass filter. And by using that high pass filter, we have to increase, or we have to passing the highest frequency, only passing the highest frequency, so that we have to use this PM5 circuit in the transmitter, okay? And in that receiver part, we have to use the DM5 circuit, because at the receiver end, we have to receive the original signal. Then we have to original signal, because we have to separate the signal means we have to separate the modulating signal and the carrier signal, okay, by using the demodulator. Then we have to receive this original signal, baseband signal, by using the PM5 circuit. And in that PM5 circuit, we have to use the low pass filter. And this low pass filter having the R and C component. These are the two components, they are connected in a series. Okay. Then by using that low pass filter, only the passing of a lowest frequency, means whatever the frequency we have received original form, means baseband signal, whatever the signal we have received in the form of baseband signal, so that we can use the DM5 circuit in the receiver. Okay. This is a very important topic related with your frequency generator or frequency modulation. Okay, this is a very important topic, and this is a very important chapter for that FM generation or FM waves. After that, generation of narrow band FM and generation of wide band FM. Okay, and we can call as a generation of FM, because most of the times we have to use the direct method and indirect method. But direct method and indirect method we have to use in a wide band FM. But in the when we have to generate the narrow band FM, that time only voltage control oscillator and the varector diode. This is a voltage control oscillator and varector diode. We have to use this. 1 minute. When we have to generate the narrow band FM, that time voltage control oscillator, this type of a circuit is used to generate the narrow band FM. But in when we have to generate the wide band FM, wide band frequency, okay, that time we have to use the direct method and indirect method. Direct method and indirect method. Most of the time, this type of a question will be asked in your examination, university examination, explaining details of narrow band FM and wide band FM. This kind of a question will be asked, explain in details of direct and indirect method for generating of a wide band FM, so that all the students should know the what are the direct method and what are the indirect method, or we can call as a direct circuit and indirect circuit. Okay, in that direct method we have to use the varector diode. Okay, varector diode is one of the circuit is used to generate the wide band FM. But some of the drawbacks is occur in the varector diode direct method, because yesterday we have seen some of the frequency or some of the wideband frequency we have to generate it by using this varector diode. In that wideband frequency, having the it should be stability of that signal. Stability means जो भी तुम्हारा signal रहेगा, whatever the signal is stable. For example, FM broadcasting station is broadcast the different channel. That time we have the receiver. आपन क्या करते हैं, कि अपने को अगर 92.3 FM अगर चाहिए, 93.2 FM, 93.5 FM, जो भी अपने को चैनल चाहिए वो अपन क्या करते हैं, ट्यून करते हैं, राइट। ट्यून करते हैं, इसका मतलब क्या होता है, स्टेबिलिटी। मीन्स वो ट्यून करने के बाद वहीं पे स्टॉप हो जाता है, मीन्स स्टेबल रहता है वो चैनल, क्या रहता है, स्टेबल रहता है। सो दैट द स्टेबिलिटी इज अ मोर इम्पोर्टेंट फैक्टर टू जनरेट द और टू ब्रॉडकास्टिंग ऑफ अ वाइड बैंड FM। सो द स्टेबिलिटी इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पैरामीटर और स्टेबिलिटी इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर related to that wideband FM, where in that direct method and indirect method some of the stability is present or some of the stability is not present. But when we have to use direct method for generating the wideband FM, that time the stability is not constant, means stability is not steady, means it is not a constant, it is a variable, means jo bhi tumhari frequency rahengi, agar for example FM broadcasting se ek channel launch kiya hai ya broadcast kiya hai, theek hai, to apne ko wo tune karna hai, to apan wo tune achhi tarah se nahi kar pate. Agar 98.30 agar mujhe channel chahiye, 98.3 megahertz ki wo frequency ko mujhe tune karna hai, kyunki uske upar ek channel hai radio FM jo bhi rahega, ठीक है, वो चैनल को मुझे क्या करना है, ट्यून करना है। ट्यून करना है इसका मतलब क्या है, सेलेक्ट करना है मुझे वो चैनल। बट व्हेन वी हैव टू यूज द डायरेक्ट मेथड एंड व्हेन वी हैव टू यूज द वेक्टर मेथड टू जनरेटिंग द वाइड बैंड फ्रीक्वेंसी, दैट टाइम द स्टेबिलिटी इज नॉट ऑकर ड्यूरिंग दैट रिसीविंग दैट सिग्नल, मीन्स जो भी सिग्नल मुझे ब्रॉडकास्ट करना है उसके लिए स्टेबिलिटी मेंटेन नहीं होती है व्हेन वी हैव टू यूज द वेक्टर डायोड एंड in that direct, when you have to use this direct method, that time the stability is not steady or stability is not constant during that transmission of a FM signal due to that direct method or due to that varector circuit. In that varector circuit we have to use this kind of a circuit and varector diode circuit. Why we are using the varector diode? Because this diode is operating in the negative bias voltage or negative voltage, and this is a second left part is you can see here the LC filter, LC tank filter or LC oscillator filter bolte hai usko, jo ki carrier frequency kya karta hai, wo generate karta hai, means whatever the carrier frequency is generated by using this oscillator tuned circuit, okay, aur wo tuned circuit generate hota hai along with that negative bias voltage. ओके, जब नेगेटिव बायस वोल्टेज जो वैरेक्टर डायोड जब यूज करता हो तो उस टाइम पे नेगेटिव बायस वोल्टेज ही यूज करते हैं, बिकॉज द वैरेक्टर डायोड इज ऑपरेटेड इन अ नेगेटिव बायस वोल्टेज, सो दैट वी कैन यूज द नेगेटिव वोल्टेज फॉर ऑपरेटिंग ऑफ अ वैरेक्टर डायोड, ओके, एंड ड्यू टू दैट वैरेक्टर डायोड टू जनरेट द वाइड बैंड फ्रीक्वेंसी due to the tank circuit, but when it is generate the wideband frequency, but the frequency will not be steady or the frequency will not be constant, so that we cannot use, most of the time we cannot use the direct method to generating or to broadcasting of a FM signal. Most of the time or maximum time the FM station is broadcasting the signal, the broadcasting of a FM channel transmitted by indirect method or transmitted by different type of indirect method, different type of indirect circuit, okay. And today we have discussed what exactly which circuit is used to generate the wideband frequency by using the indirect method, okay. Direct method already we have discussed in the last lecture, in the previous lecture, okay. This is because this also circuit is asked in your examination, ओके, उस टाइम पे आपको एग्जाम में ये सर्किट ड्रॉ करना पड़ता है और सर्किट ड्रॉ करने के बाद उसके ऊपर एक्सप्लेनेशन लिखना पड़ेगा आपको, तभी आपको मार्क्स मिलेंगे. सो दिस इज द सर्किट टू जनरेट द वाइड बैंड फ्रीक्वेंसी बाय यूजिंग द वेक्टर डायोड इन द डायरेक्ट मेथड, ओके. सेकंड थिंग इज दैट